Hello everyone, this is Dr. MK and I'm happy to meet you all after a week time. So today we are going to discuss a reaction known as Corey-Fuchs reaction. This reaction was reported in the year 1972 and the journal name is Tetrahedral Letters. Coming to the importance of this Corey-Fuchs reaction is, this reaction involves carbon-carbon triple bond formation. And in terms of exam point of view, this reaction may be useful to IIT JAM, SET, GATE and CSIR aspirants. And by considering these all aspects, I'm going to discuss in this video what do you mean by Corey-Fuchs reaction and what is the mechanism involved in this reaction and this utility. And finally, I'm going to discuss a CSIR question which was asked in December 2011. In general, Corey-Fuchs reaction involves two steps. That is, in the first step, when benzaldehyde reacts with carbon tetrabromide and triphenylphosphine in the presence of zinc dust will provide an intermediate product. That intermediate product has to be treated with N-butyl lithium followed by quenching with water will give the final product, that is phenylacetylene. And in this case, this is a first step and this one is a second step. As I said already, in the first step, there is a formation of an intermediate product and this compound is called as dibromoalkene. This dibromoalkene is treated under the condition 2 will give the final product. And this is the overall process involving in Corey-Fuchs reaction. Now let us discuss the mechanism of this reaction. First, let us see the formation of this dibromoalkene. So in the case of mechanism, initially what will happen? Carbon tetrabromide and triphenylphosphine reaction is taking place. So in this case, this lone pair electron on phosphorus atom try to approach this bromine atom. As a result, this bond is broken and this electron will move towards carbon atom and lead it to the formation of a phosphonium salt, where this part is called as cation and this part is called as anion. So once this ion pair is formed means, so next step will be this minus charge will approach phosphorus atom. As a result, this bromine will be leaving, will lead to the formation of a new phosphonium salt. In this case, you can find a new bond formation between carbon atom and phosphorus atom. Okay, so once this salt is formed means, the next step will be this bromide will be attacking this bromine atom. As a result, this electron will move towards carbon atom, will lead to the formation of a compound known as elide. And this elide can be represented in the form of double bond between carbon and phosphorus. Meanwhile, what will happen? In this step, you can see Br2 is leaving. So already I said there is a use of zinc dust in this case. So what will happen here is that zinc will be reacting with whatever bromine left in this step and it will lead to the formation of zinc bromide. Now let us discuss the reaction of this phosphorus elide with this benzaldehyde. So this reaction is known as Wittig reaction. So it is a well-known reaction. So what will happen here? There is a carbon-carbon double bond formation and the byproduct will be triphenylphosphine oxide. And you can see here this oxygen and this triphenyl phosphorus part will be making a new bond, that is a double bond. And here this part and this part are connected together through a CC double bond. So this dibromoalkene intermediate has been formed. So let me explain the mechanism involved in Wittig reaction here. So what will happen? This anionic part of this elide will approach here and this electron will be moving towards oxygen atom, will lead to the formation of a betaine intermediate. So once it is formed means this electron will approach phosphorus atom, will lead to the formation of an intermediate called oxaphosphatane. So in this case, this four member ring will be opening in this fashion. As a result, you will get the formation of this dibromoalkene along with the byproduct, that is triphenylphosphine oxide. So this is about the formation of dibromoalkene intermediate, that is step 1. Now let us discuss the step 2. So in generally, if you check with the textbook, they have given in two pathways. So it's my duty to discuss both pathways and finally I will tell you which is the correct way. So let us discuss the path A. So in this case, what will happen? This dibromoalkene reacts with N-butyl lithium. We know that this N-butyl lithium will be separating in this fashion, that is butyl minus and lithium positive charge. So in this case, this base will abstract this proton As a result, this electron will shift towards this carbon atom and bromine will be leaving. So this part is said to be beta elimination. Say for example, this is a leaving group, this is alpha carbon and this is beta carbon, and you can say this as a beta elimination, and it will lead to the formation of a carbon-carbon triple bond, and you have one bromine atom. So what will happen in the next step? One more mole of n-butyl lithium reacting with this alkane compound. So what will happen is, here you have a minus charge and it will attack this bromine atom, and this will be leaving as n-butyl bromide, and this part will be shifting towards this carbon atom. So it will form lithium acetylide. So this species is to be lithium acetylide. So once this lithium acetylide is formed, means it will be quenched with water. So what will happen, this minus part will abstract this proton of water. So what will happen, this electron will be shifting towards oxygen atom, and this lithium plus and this OH minus will be leaving as lithium hydroxide, will provide the final product, that is phenylacetylene. So this is about path A. Now let us discuss path B. So in path B, what will happen, this minus part of n-butyl lithium will approach this bromine atom. As a result, this electron will be shifting towards this carbon atom. So what will happen here? So this carbon is having minus charge, and the counter cation, that is lithium, will be connected here. And you can also draw this compound in this fashion, that is a bond between carbon and lithium. So here it is mentioned, there is a bond between carbon and lithium. So once this intermediate is formed, so it will undergo alpha elimination. So that means here itself the elimination is taking place. That means this electron will come here and this part will be leaving. So overall lithium bromide will be removed. As a result, it will form an intermediate known as carbene. So this carbene intermediate, you can imagine in this way. So it can be drawn in this way, that is this one. In carbene, you have two orbitals. That is, one is this one, another one is this one, and you have two electron in one orbital. So this is a general structure of a carbene. So once this carbene is formed, means what will happen, this electron will come here and this hydrogen will be shifting here. So this is about 1-2 hydrogen shift will be taking place. So once this process is formed, means you will get the final product, that is phenylacetylene. Now let us come to a conclusion, which one is correct. And most of these textbooks have given this pathway, and if you ask me, means so this is the correct pathway, because in recent years some literature reports, they have proved the formation of this carbene intermediate. So and through that process only this reaction is taking place, that is Corey-Fuchs reaction. So this is a correct way of understanding the mechanism, and this is a wrong way. Okay, so if you are writing any examination, means it is not a problem, you can follow any pathway. Suppose if you are going for an interview or viva, means you need to produce this pathway only, this is a correct one. Okay, so if you want more information, means I have given the corresponding paper, that is literature link in the description section. You can get the information from the paper. Okay, so now let us discuss the scope of Corey-Fuchs reaction. So it is a so much important reaction, because whatever the condition that is given, that is carbon tetrabromide, triphenylphosphine, zinc dust and n-butyl lithium excess. So the condition is, if you change the electrophile, you will get different kind of products, that is this one. So this electrophile will be occupied this place. What are the electrophile that you can use? You can use acid as electrophile, and if you use acid, means instead of this electrophile, that is you will get hydrogen atom. If you use carbon dioxide, means you will get CO2H, that is carboxylic acid. You can also use alkyl halide, you will get here alkyl group. And you can also use, that is ethyl chloroformate. So in this case you will end up with the formation of an ester. So this reaction has so much of variability. So that is why it is so much important in terms of synthetic organic chemistry. So the major advantage is you can form CC triple bond. Along with that, if you change the electrophile, you will get different kind of products. So that is why this reaction is important. Okay. So now let us discuss some of the examples based on Corey-Fuchs reaction. So you can see here, so this is a big molecule. Don't get confused with the molecule. We know that the reaction part here only. So you do not have to keep in mind this part. So you can simply consider this as a RCHO, simple aldehyde. And the condition they have given is carbon tetrabromide, triphenylphosphine and zinc, and followed by that n-butyl lithium, then ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is a mild acid. So acid will donate hydrogen plus, that is proton. So at the end of this molecule, that is a terminal position of this alkane, hydrogen will be added. That is the thing. So, and you can check here. So there is a formation of a triple bond, and at the end you get hydrogen atom. And next example, what we have is, that is same condition, that is CBr4 triphenyl phosphine N-butyl lithium followed by methyl iodide. So this methyl iodide will be written in this way. So what will happen here? So once this alkyne is formed, means this anion will be approaching this methyl functional group. As a result, this iodine will be leaving as I minus. So as a result, at the end you will get methyl group, and this is a product, and the yield of this reaction is 75%, and this reaction yield is 90%. And we have one more example. So in this case, you have two aldehyde function group. You can see here, one aldehyde here and another aldehyde is given here, and the electrophile, what they have used is ethyl chloroformate. So this ethyl chloroformate can be drawn in this way, that is Cl C double bond O OET. And in this case, what will be forming is ester group will be attached at the terminal position of the alkane. So what will happen? So once this acetylide anion is formed, means so it will attack here, and chlorine is a very good leaving group, and this part only will be leaving. So at the end you will get, that is ester formation or C triple bond C double bond O ET, that is ester. So you have two aldehyde functional group. So at both end you will get, that is ester functional groups. So you get this as a product, and the yield of the reaction is 90%. You can check here. Okay. So this is about the examples of Corey-Fuchs reaction. Now let us discuss one CSIR question that is asked in December 2011. So the question is, they have given an aldehyde and it is treated with CBr4 triphenyl phosphine and N-butyl lithium, and this N-butyl lithium CBr4 triphenyl phosphine means you can conclude that the reaction is Corey-Fuchs reaction. So we know that Corey-Fuchs reaction will get alkane as a product, and if you check with the option, you have only one option, that is option D, that is a correct one, and the question is solved. So in the second step, what will happen is, it is treated, this compound A, it is treated with phenyl azide and copper sulfate sodium ascorbate. So what will happen is, it lead to the formation of a compound known as triazole. So this position you need to start numbering 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 1,4 substituted triazole. And this reaction is known as click reaction. So I will make a separate video on this reaction. First, let us understand some basic concept in this video. So what will happen here? So this azide can be drawn in this way, that is nitrogen, double bond nitrogen, double bond nitrogen, and single bond phenyl. So this end you have minus charge, and this part you have positive charge. What will happen? This electron will approach this part, and this pi electron will move towards this nitrogen atom. As a result, this electron will be shifting towards the nitrogen atom, which is having positive charge. So what will happen here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So this after reaction, this bond, triple bond will be converted into double bond. So okay. So you have this end is connected to nitrogen atom, and here you have phenyl group, and here you have a single bond nitrogen, and here you have double bond nitrogen, and there is a single bond between this nitrogen atom and this carbon atom, and it will lead to the formation of this triazole, 1,4 disubstituted triazole. That's all about Corey-Fuchs reaction. So guys, if you have any questions or doubts based on Corey-Fuchs reaction means, you can put it in the comment section. I will give reply to your comments. And if you find the video is very much useful means, you can like the video and you can share the video with your friends. And do not forget to subscribe the channel and ask your friends to subscribe the channel. And I will meet you all with more interesting topics. Until then, take care. Bye.